on the BBC Panorama show called America's Gun Addiction. Their investigation shows how shockingly easy it is to legally buy an assault weapon. No questions asked. And joining me now is BBC correspondent Hillary Anderson, who went undercover to buy an AR-15. Hillary, thank you for joining me. I watched the Panorama report you did tonight with... It wasn't really shock, actually, because I have known for a while that 40% of all gun trades in America are done without any form of background checks. But to see the ease with which you went to a gun show and just bought a Bushmaster AR-15 assault rifle, the exact same weapon that Adam Lanza used at Sandy Hook, was pretty disturbing. Let's take a look at a clip from your investigation.
This private seller had an AR-15 for sale, the type of weapon Adam Lanza used.
This is a Bushmaster?
He just wanted cash. No test, no questions asked.
So, this is the gun I bought. It's an AR-15 semi-automatic weapon. I didn't have to fill out any paperwork at all to buy it. I don't have to license it now that I own it. That's how easy it is to buy and own a gun in Texas.
Were you surprised, Hillary, at the ease with which you bought that rifle?
Well, like you, I knew what the law was. I know about the gun show loophole. I know that you can go in and do this, but when you're actually in a gun show, you know, and you find that you want to buy an AR-15 and that all you have to do is literally hand over the cash, the guy didn't even ask for my driver's license. I showed it to him, but he wasn't interested. I asked for a receipt. He wasn't interested. Yeah, it's pretty amazing just how easy it is, because if I can buy a gun, you know, then, you know, anybody can, like
I
said.
Are you an American citizen or resident?
I am an American citizen and resident.
But it wouldn't have made any difference, presumably. You could have been a British citizen and still done the same thing.
Well, legally, you're supposed to be an American citizen. Legally, you're not supposed to be mentally ill. Legally, you're not supposed to be a criminal. But the fact is that in a gun show, there, you know, if you're buying from a private dealer, which is very different than if you're buying from a licensed dealer, if you're buying from a private dealer, nobody asks any questions. So you can really do whatever you want. And there's no follow-up in Texas because you don't have to license the gun or register it after you buy it. You can just, you know, go put it in your car and drive home with it and do what you want with it. Now, if you buy from a licensed dealer at a gun show or anywhere else, it's a completely different story. That's when you have to pass this instant background check. But we did a lot of work looking into the detail of what this background check entails for the documentary that I made, and found out that because we were focusing very much on the issue of mentally ill people in America and whether or not they can buy guns. So yes, they can easily buy them through private dealers because there are no checks at all. But can they pass the instant background check? Well, that's where it gets really interesting, because the one question on the instant background check form about mental illness basically says this. It says, if you've been adjudicated by a court of law or a commission or a board as mentally defective, they call it, or if you've been involuntarily committed to a psychiatric institution of some kind, you cannot legally pass that background check and buy a gun. But that leaves a glaring hole, because if you've been mentally ill for decades or spent decades in a, you know, voluntarily putting yourself in a psychiatric unit, there's nothing to stop you from passing that background check. So either which way, it's easy to get a gun if you're mentally ill or not.
Yeah, I mean, the bottom line is you could have been Hannibal Lecter for all they knew. They didn't care. And that's the reason this gun show loophole is so potentially dangerous, because if you are criminally minded or mentally insane and intent on causing some devastating atrocity, of course that's how you're going to try and secure your weapons, because it's the easiest way of doing it. And let me ask you, did you keep the AR-15? What did you do with it?
No, of course not. We needed to offload it as quickly as we could. We're, you know, filmmakers, documentary makers, journalists. We wanted to make a point, and we sold it back to a licensed dealer and got receipts and the correct paperwork and made sure we sold it to reputable people. But it's interesting, you know, the figure of how many, what percentage of American guns are sold this way. You mentioned that it was around 40%. Now, that's a very disputed figure, and nobody really knows how many of America's guns are sold through this loophole with no paperwork, because there is no paperwork, so they can't know. The 40% figure comes from the 1990s. I'm going with a figure of somewhere between 14 and 40% as a safe figure, but really, to be honest, nobody knows. It's just a lot of guns.
Well, it was a fascinating report. We've talked about this loophole ad nauseum in the last 3 months, but to see you actually go to a Texas gun show and secure this weapon, the one that, as I say, slaughtered those children at Sandy Hook, was pretty devastating television. Hillary, thank you for joining me.